warning signs keep piling up for the greater Boston economy, especially for the tourism and hospitality industries. The head of the region's top business group is speaking out to our political analyst, John Keller, about what needs to happen for the Golden Goose to thrive again.
If you thought the local economic damage done by COVID was over, think again. Did you know Boston's hotel industry has been hit so hard by the tourism slump? The landmark 1,000-room Sheraton Boston is still closed?
There's certainly some challenges that we're experiencing now and on the horizon.
And for Jim Rooney, president of the Greater Boston Chamber of Commerce, the key to recovery for tourism and our overall business climate lies in quick action by politicians more adept at squabbling than acting. In Washington, where Rooney wants to see an infrastructure deal finally pass and Trump-era tariffs lifted to help get supply chains moving, and on Beacon Hill, where he wants an end to the arguing over how to spend our $5 billion federal windfall.
Let's get something done in the next 3 months, and then if there's more to debate about what programs in housing should we fund, have that debate maybe in a phase two. Americans and the business community in particular want to see some signals that there can be urgency, that there can be compromise, that there can be collaboration, and that government can get the job done. There's a big hunger for that.
And Rooney echoes the warning of Governor Baker's new Future of Work study. We're not going back to the way business used to be done.
It's all online now. So people just have to embrace the fact that they have to learn the new ways that life is lived, commerce is conducted.
John, when it comes to tourism, no question that some people are still skittish. Things are very, very expensive as well. What did Rooney have to say about two things that have been in the news lately? Lagging vaccination rates and rising inflation.
Well, David, I'm paraphrasing here, but with regard to inflation, Rooney urged lawmakers to cool it on the direct subsidies to citizens and instead target funds to more specific areas of need, like the explosive number of drug overdose cases. Just putting more money into people's pockets, more demand, less supply, boom, inflation. And on the vaccinations, he was almost speechless with shock and horror at the backlash against vaccinations and the fact that things seems to have stalled out. He says this could be one of the single biggest factors holding business and economic growth back in the future as businesses try to deal with that situation. David?
Yeah, so a lot of people thought we'd be getting back to normal very quickly. Things not quite there yet. John Keller, right. Thank you so much for your report. Appreciate it.